Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you how to compute a running total with DAX. But first of all, what is a running total? Here, I have a report that shows the year, the month, the sales amount, and then a classical year-to-date. What does year-to-date do? Year-to-date computes a running total in the year. Indeed, it will reset at the end of every year. You see that it starts growing until it reaches the end of the year. It reaches its maximum value and then it resets again and starts counting again. Year-to-date has a specific DAX function to compute it. What if I want to compute a running total? A running total starts the same way as a year-to-date, but it does not reset at the end of the year. There is no function to compute a running total in DAX, so we need to author it by ourselves. And in order to do that, we need to think, before writing it out, the logic that we want to implement. What I want to do is, for every row of the report, I want to compute the sum of the sales amount for all the dates that happen to be before the last visible date in the current context. So, if you are in August, what I want to compute is the sum of all dates before August. With that idea in mind, we can start writing code. The running total is requires you to use calculate, so we start with new measure and we call it sales running total. First, we need to understand what is the last date in the current filter context. To do that, we store it in a variable, we call it max date, which is just the maximum of the date column, date. Now, maxDate contains the last date that is visible in the context. Then, I will need to use calculate in order to compute the sales amount for all the dates before this date. So, I can create straight my new variable, result, that uses calculate. It computes just sales amount, or whatever measure I'm interested in computer running total on. And then I apply a filter that the date need to be less or equal than the max date. I also get rid of any filter on the date. So, what I'm saying is that I want to compute the sales amount for all the dates before the last date, all the dates before the last date. Once I wrote it, I have an error, which is... Oh, I'm missing the return part. I created a variable result. I just need to add return result. Much better. Now I format it as a decimal number. Finally, I put it in the report to see whether it's working or not. And you can see that it starts the same way as a year-to-date, but then when it reaches the next year, year-to-date resets and starts counting again, whereas our running total goes on computing the value. It's a simple function that proves to be extremely useful. Besides, it's worth noting that when we speak about running total, we quite always think at dates, because running total works very well with dates. But you can implement a very similar logic whenever you have an attribute that can be sorted in some way. Imagine, for example, that all of your customers have a customer class, it can be platinum, gold, or silver, and you want to compute a running total on top of it. So you want to see the sales of platinum plus gold, the sales of platinum plus gold plus silver. We are not going to use alphabetical sorting. We have the customer class code that defines the sorting, and because we have a sorting, we can implement a comparison operator, and we use the very same pattern to implement this feature. Indeed, if we take a look at the code of running total sales customer, you see that it's nearly the same code. This time, instead of using max, we used selected value, because we have only one value available. Both max and selected value would return the same result, whereas in the date max was the right thing, because we had multiple dates selected. Here we have only one. So we take the class number, which is currently visible, and we compute the sales amount for all the class number which happen to be before the current class number. And then we get rid of any filter from the customer class, exactly as we did earlier. So, running total is a common technique, pretty useful to author your DAX code. Enjoy DAX!